أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم، حمدا لا يتناهى، ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. جزاكم الله خير for coming and ask الله سبحانه وتعالى make it in our balance in front of Allah عز وجل. Still with the Salah and the benefit of the Salah. And I said every single step coming to the masjid and doing anything is rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just the intention is rewarded. Coming to the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded. Doing the dua is rewarded. Praying the two rak'ah at the masjid is rewarded. Also waiting for the Salah is rewarded. The angel will do dua for you. Repeating the word of Azan behind the Muazzin is also rewarded. Also, when the Adhan is done and the Iqama Shaitan will run away from you, when you do Takbirat al-Ihram is rewarded, making the Saf straight is rewarded, saying Rabbana wa laka alhamdu, when the Imam saying Sami Allahu liman hamida is also rewarded from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means every single thing without exception is rewarded from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also with the Jama'ah, you are a little bit safe from the يعني forgetness and more خشوع. You will hear the Quran in the Jahri prayer. You will be rewarded of Umran al-Masajid by attending it and spending some of your income for it. Also when you are cooperating with the other for the obeying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will be rewarded for that. Laziness will go away from you. It is also putting down the shaitan, because he was ordered to pray and to do sujood, he refused the order of Allah to do the sujood. And we are ordered to do, when we do, and especially with the jama'ah, as Allah says, وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ, you will be rewarded. Also, you will be safe from النفاق, as Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said the hadith about that. Also, you will get the barakah of the dua of the people and dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, love and affection and respect to each other and the unity. Also saying Ameen with the Imam, a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you'll be rewarded for it. Every single step for every single prayer, you are rewarded for it. In the Jum'ah, especially the steps is very high rewarded. Every single step, Siyamu sanatin wa qiyamaha, Siyaman qiyam of a whole year for every single step. From your home to the place of the masjid or the place of the prayer, 100 step will be 100 year. 200 step, 200 year. 300 step if you are going walking to the masjid, 300 step, 300 years. Subhanallah, look how very high reward from Allah. Benefit of the jama'ah, you will get also learn whatever you does not know from your religion. And also achieving ubudiyyah, achieving of the worshiping of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also stop with yashhadu laka al-makanu wal-malaikatu. The place itself will be witness for you. The place you are praying for, that do a lot of sujood in different places, because the place itself will do witness for you in front of Allah, and the place will cry for you. Angels also will do dua for you. It is light upon light, light of the salah upon light of the iman upon light of the masabid upon light from Allah upon light in your heart upon light on your right, light on your left, light in front of you, light behind you, light over you, light under you, all of it barakah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Most beloved amal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the salah. And especially with the jama'ah, it would increase your iman for every single step, hasana, a good deeds. Also holding fast with the robe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the direct connection between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember when I said the salah itself contains shahadatayn, contain the salah, contain the zakah, contain the hajj, contain the jihad, contain a lot of things from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the salah itself. Also, every single prayer, Allah will prepare a place for you in the jannah. Every single time you go, الله سبحانه وتعالى will prepare a place for you in الجنة. Also one of the seven people will be shaded by the shade from Allah. And when the sun will be so near to the head and so hot at the time, then one of them is رجل قلبه معلق بالمساجد. A man, his heart was attached in masjid. Every time he go out, he will come back. Allah, in hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, one of the benefit of the jama'ah in the masjid, every time you go, Allah will be happy. The hadith exactly saying like that. Allah يفرح بقدومك. Allah will be happy that you come to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the masjid. Also in the hadith of السلسلة الصحيحة, 598, you will be في ضمان, ضاد, ميم, ألف, نون. ضمان contain a lot of meaning. You will be guaranteed from Allah, protected from Allah, saved from Allah, helped by Allah. Every single meaning around that is daman. As long as you come into Allah, there is no doubt one of the benefits of the salah, forgiveness of your sin, accepting of tawbah. When you read ayat al-kursi after the prayer, nothing, hadith of Rasulullah saying the meaning, nothing prevent you from entering al-jannah except if you die. Means you die, you go to Jannah right away. Just you read ayat al-kursi after the jama'ah. Accepting of any dua you do after the prayer. Also safety from shaitan. With Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, some people, the benefit of the jama'ah. Some people, if they do not do the jama'ah, even they are three or more, shaitan will control them. For that you will be out of the control of the shaitan if you do the jama'ah. Also the knots. The knot done upon the head when you die, shaitan did it. Three knots, all of them will be solved by dhikr of Allah and by wudu and by the salah also. Also, you will never feel depression, you will never feel sad, you will never feel sorrow when you do the dhikr of Allah. Also, when you go in and for the prayer little bit early, the time you are waiting for the salah counted as a salah also. You are rewarded for making the saf straight. Rewarded for the subhanallah, alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, a lot of benefits, subhanallah. Only for the jama'ah. يقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من الهيثم والطبراني والبزار المسجد بيت كل تقي. The masjid is the house of every pious, every taqi, every righteous person. Masjid is his home. Because you go, then you come to Allah. You go, then you come to house of Allah. You go, then you... Allah considered in this hadith as your house. وتكفل الله لمن كان المسجد بيته بالروح والرحمة. And Allah guarantee to the one who considers the house of Allah as his house. His heart is connected to masjid. He loves to come to in. He never will miss any jama'ah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will relieve him from every wrong, relieve him from every haram, relieve him from every depression, from every يعني, hatred thing, and rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that, and whoever house of Allah is his own house, his heart attached to it, he loved it, nothing prevent him from it, al-jawazu ala al-sirat. Rasulullah saying this hadith, he will pass upon al-sirat, which it is in the middle of Jahannam, sharper than the sword, and very, very, very thin, thinner than the hair, than one hair. He will pass over it, some people they will fall down, some people will be punished, some people will be hawks, will take them and put him in Jahannam. But if you're praying with the jama'ah in the house of Allah, it is in your heart and your heart full of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Rasulullah say you will pass upon al-sirat very easy. Where? In the same hadith, ila ridwanillah ila al-jannah, to the pleasure of Allah, to the jannah. Other than salat al-duha, the reward of it is equal to the reward of hajj and umrah. And also in the hadith I mentioned, every single step to the masjid in al-jum'ah is 1 year qiyaman siyam, equal to the reward of 1 year at the daytime siyam and the night time qiyam. Look, subhanallah, every single step coming to the jum'ah equal every one step 1 year, another step another year, 100 step 100 years. The hadith in Nasa'i 1383. And I was with the types of the people in Ramadan. I mentioned already 8 different types of the people in Ramadan, the last time. It's still 2 types. هم المؤمنون حقا, the real and the true believer. من يحافظ على الصلوات الخمس في جماعة ويصوم رمضان ويقوم الليل ويحاول زيارة أو زيادة أو تقوية إيمانه بفعل الخيرات والبعد عن المحرمات. The real مؤمن who take care of the five daily prayer in جماعة and he fast in Ramadan, because I'm talking still about Ramadan, but the next step will come inshallah. And he do قيام الليل and he try to increase his إيمان and her إيمان for the ladies and he doing all the goodness and he be far from all haram. هم عمار المساجد. Real مؤمن of the one who do يعني make the masjid alive by attending. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say إذا رأيتم الرجل يعتاد المساجد فاشهدوا له بالإيمان. If you see anybody coming regularly to the masjid, give him a witness that he is a mu'min. If you see anybody coming regularly to the masajid, give a witness to him that he is a mu'min. وقال الله عز وجل إنما يعمر مساجد الله من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر. The one who do عمران of the masajid, the one who believe in Allah and the last day. They love التبكير to the masajid. They love to come early. They love الأذان and they love to do it and they love to hear it. They love to purify the masjid of Allah and clean it. They love also serving the house of Allah. They never lose the تكبيرة الإحرام. They never lose the صف الأول, the first صف. They respect the house of Allah and they respect the people in the house of Allah. Those the one who actually spiritually and materialistic, they are very good because they are connected to Allah. Also there is another one is higher and better. The one who prays the fara'id and increase the sunan and the tatawu and the qiyam al-layl and salat al-duha in Ramadan also, and they do more prayers of all different kinds, salat al-istikhara, salat al-tawbah, salat al-hajah, with the fasting of Ramadan and reading of the Quran and doing also the fasting of the Monday and Thursday other than Ramadan and 13, 14, 15 other than Ramadan from the Arabic calendar. And they also, they fast the day of Al-Waqfa, they fast the day of Tasu'an Ashura, they do the zikr of Allah. All of this, they are the best one kind of Allah, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah to make us one of them. Ibn Taymiyyah saying that, إِنَّ فِي الدُّنْيَا جَنَّةَ مَنْ لَمْ يَدْخُلْهَا لَمْ يَدْخُلْ جَنَّةَ الْآخِرَةَ. إِنَّ فِي الدُّنْيَا جَنَّةَ مَنْ لَمْ يَدْخُلْهَا لَمْ يَدْخُلْ جَنَّةَ الْآخِرَةَ. He said, in the worldly life, there is a Jannah, which it is this Jannah. Jannah with Allah. Jannah to make your heart pure. Jannah to pray in jama'ah and enjoy the prayer. Jannah to be connected to Allah. In the worldly life there is a Jannah. Whoever does not enter it, he will never enter Jannah in al-akhirah. In the worldly life, Jannah of Allah. In the worldly life with the Salah, with the jama'ah, with the reading of the Quran, with being connected to Him, with remembering Him all the time. Whoever does not enter the Jannah in dunya, he will never enter it in al-akhirah. And from the book of الوابل الصيب من الكلم الطيب لابن القيم. From the book of الوابل الصيب من الكلم الطيب. Different pages, different يعني version of the book. Some pages you find 40 because I announced that before page 40. Some of it I found out 23. He said the people and the salah five different kinds. People with the salah five different kinds. Either do you remember the hadith we take before? Not everybody praying is actually praying. You find in front of you 100 people praying. Never be all of them will be equal. They will never. Ibn al-Qayyim in that book, the summary of it, not all of it, he divides the people five. Some people praying, but they will be punished. Some people praying, but they will be account about their prayer. Some people praying, and it will be forgiveness for them. Some people praying, and they will get a reward. Not only forgiving for the sin, it will be higher, rewarded. Some people, they will be closer to Allah because of their prayer. We ask Allah to make us one of them, say Ameen. For that there is five different types of the people. Look to yourself, you are which one of them. Some people, they will be, try to concentrate with me, will be punished. Some people will be mu'aqab. Some will be muhasab. They will be account about it. Some will be mukaffarun an, will be, his sin will be expiated, will be deleted. Some people muthab, he will be rewarded. Some people muqarrab min Rabbi, he will be closer to Allah because of the prayer. For that the one who is being punished, Allah will punish him. And we will see why. The one will be account, Allah will account him for this prayer. The one who will be expiated, Allah will expiate some of his sins because of the prayer. Some will be rewarded, getting a reward, a remark. Higher degrees because of the salah. Some will be الله عز وجل will make him closer to him because he is closer to Allah in his salah. Sometimes you will pray and you are busy. You are not close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, let us take one by one. The one first one, mu'aqab. This is the one who do wrong against himself. He does not do the wudu right. He does not do it in its time. He does not do the conditions of it. He does not do the pillars of it. He does not do the sunan of it. He does not do the wajibat of it. He doesn't know the shurut of it, the conditions of it. No perfect ruku', no, he is praying, but no perfect ruku', no perfect sujood. For that, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah قال هذا معاقب لأنه لم يأتي بها. He will be punished because he doesn't do it actually. Yes, stand and going up and down, but he doesn't do nothing. For that, that kind of people, even he is praying, but still he will be punished because he does not do it as it should be done. No shurut, no wajibat, no sunan, no arkan, no anything. Does he stand with the people who are standing, going down, going up, and that's it? He doesn't know even what he is reading. Second type of the people was the prayer. Then the one Allah will account him. He do it in its time. And he try as much as he can, some of the pillar he do, some of the condition he do, some of the wajibat he do. Wudu he do it perfect. Because the one before, no wudu, no ruku', no sujood, he mix it up, and he doesn't know what he's doing. But this one, he do what should be done. لكنه قد ضيع مجاهدة نفسه في الوسوسة إن دخل في الصلاة. What the problem of this one will be, why he will be account? Just he enters the prayer, the shaitan whisper to him. And he keep going on with the whispering. He will keep going on with the whispering. Shaitan will whisper to him, and he's still going on with him. For that, he will lose a lot of his reward, and he will be account. Why do not struggle against the shaitan to stop that waswas, which it is whispering? For that he will get out of it. He doesn't know what he said. He doesn't know, and does not concentrate, have no khushu in his prayer. That people who go, his mind goes away for the dunya. He doesn't even hear what the imam read. He doesn't, only he hear assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. You'll find him who wake up. Then he remember the dunya and whatever in the dunya. And his heart attached to dunya. He want to leave it. For that, this kind of people is the one, always if you read 5-6 ayat, they will complain. For others, they don't want to sit. Because their mind connected to dunya, their heart connected to the dunya. They don't want to learn what Allah say, what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say. In the salah, they don't want to be connected to Allah. Oh, Shaykh, why you make it long? It's actually is not long. Heavy for him. Because of the waswas, because of the shaitan. Because if you enjoy it, you will never be heavy to you. Look to yourself with something you love and you sit 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour, 4 hour, 1 day, 2 day, no problem for you because you love it. But when you don't like it, 5 minutes will be too much for you. Same, if you love the prayer and you concentrate in it, maybe you do the pillars of it, but still you are busy in it. Number three, Salah will be expiation for some of his sin. He will do the pillars, he will do the conditions, he will do the arkan, he will do the wajibat, he will do the thing. And he was also, the first one before, he will be going with the whispering. That one he will not go with the whispering. He will struggle against the shaitan. And he will be يعني, busy with the struggling against the shaitan. He doesn't want the shaitan to steal anything from his prayer. For that in his prayer he is in salah and jihad. Jihad was against his shaitan. Jihad against his own self to improve his salah. This kind of people will be his sins expiated. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove the waswas, the shaitan from him, and he will be expiate some of his sin because he's struggling against the shaitan, struggling against his own bad desire. You know, sometimes while you are praying, some of the things you love or some of the things you want to remember, it will come to you. If you struggle against that, it will be that kind of people will be expiation for the sin. Some of your sin will be deleted. Number four, he will be rewarded. We ask Allah make us from that kind and the next kind also. He will be closer to Allah, not only rewarded, closer. The one who is rewarded, Allah will give him reward. He do it perfect. He do it complete. He do the right of it. He do the pillars of it. He do the limits of it. He do the conditions of it. He do the sunan of it. And his heart is connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His heart does not get far away from the prayer. And also, he will be no waswas, no whispering of the shaitan. having خشوع and all of his concern directly to do it as it should be done, do it perfect and do it complete. His heart full of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with it. He do it as it should be done. He said, this is the people will be rewarded for it, will be rewarded. No waswas, no shaitan. At the same time, he tried to learn and do the prayer as it should be done. Number five, which one I'll stop with it, inshallah, or a little bit more, مُقَرَّبٌ مِّن رَبِّهِ, will be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because he tried to be closer to Allah, and the salah become a reason for him to be closer to Allah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him closer to him. And this is the highest one. We ask Allah to give it to us, say Ameen, and make us reach to that level. Who do the arkan and the wajibat and the conditions of it, and who do khushu in it, who do it perfect, who do it complete. His heart, he take it and he put it to Allah subhanahu, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His heart, that means he did it as Allah. الاستسلام لله على وفق مراد الله. Submit yourself and your will to the will of Allah, to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He looked to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala watching him. His heart full of love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His heart, he knows the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In his prayer, as if he see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No any kind of waswas, no any kind of thoughts come to him. No anything passing by his mind at all except pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no hijab between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, between that man and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and between him and Allah, a very strong tie. And there is a difference between that kind of people and other people also. For that, the difference between him and those people before, like the difference between sama and al-ard, the heaven and the sky. He is in his prayer connected to Allah. He is busy with Allah. His sweetness of the iman, he feel it. His qarirul ayn means his being closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the prayer for him is the main thing. Nothing of the dunya come to his mind in the prayer at all. فهو قرت عينه بقربه من الله عز وجل من ربه في الدنيا فأقر الله عينه بها في الآخرة وقرت عينه أيضا في الدنيا ومن قرت عينه بالله قرت به كل عين. When him he's busy with it and he's pleased with it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him closer to him, and he will be subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will be subhanahu wa ta'ala be happy with that kind of people. Those is the one will be closer to Allah because of their prayer. For that, now let us take the summary of it. Some of the people because of the prayer will be punished, some of the people will be account, some of the people will be forgiven some of their sin, some of the people will be rewarded, some of the people will be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, in your salah, never look left or right, never. Concentrate with Allah, with your mind, with your heart. Never neglect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn al-Qayyim, في الوابل الصيب قال وقد روي أن العبد إذا قام يصلي قال الله عز وجل ارفعوا الحجب فإذا التفت قال أرخوها. Ibn al-Qayyim said, narrated that when anyone praying and he stand for the prayer, Allah Azza wa Jal will say, raise up the veils between him and me. Means it will be connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he look left or look right in the prayer and busy either with the heart or with, because they give interpretation for it, that is not only by the eyes, it is also by the heart. When your heart is busy and going left and right from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, put the hijab between me and him, put the veil again between me and him. And when this veil goes down, shaitan will come and he will show you the dunya, and he will show him in his prayer whatever you like of any wrong, and he will not be concentrating. He will not be, his heart is not concentrated with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and shaitan will be making him busy. But if you are connected to Allah and you does not look left and right, not by the face, not by the heart, not by the mind. Your mind is not busy with anything else except with Allah. Your heart is not full of anything except the love of Allah. Shaitan will never come to that heart. Remember in the khutbah and coming the details more about it, when I said the thief, when he wants to steal in front of him, if there is a three houses, house of the king and house of a rich man, but no any guardian, no anything, and house of a very, very poor man does not have nothing. The thief for the king, he will never be able. He knows that there is a guardian, there is a police, there is a lot of yani, protection around it. For the poor one, he will never, shaitan will never go for the poor, because what he will get? The thief, will never go for the empty house. He will target the one who has treasures, but does not have any protection. In the salah, the same. If you are connected to Allah and your heart connected to Allah, shaitan cannot come. If your heart is empty, empty from salah, empty from khushu, empty from everything, he will leave you alone. Because if you are empty from Allah, empty from iman, what will be there? Shirk. What will be there? Darkness. What will be there? The tools of shaitan himself. For that, he doesn't need shaitan to do nothing with that house. He will target the house, the house and the heart is full of iman, but there is still some lacks, some shortening, some mistakes, some wrong. Or that this is the shaitan will target that kind. If he does not protect himself, then he will never be. For that is salah. It will bring the rizq. It will save your health. It will remove your any harm. It will be make your heart strong. Your face will have a light. You will be happy. Will remove your laziness. It will make you more stronger. It will make your chest open for any kind of goodness, any kind of iman. Because this is body, your body contain to material, and the food is the material for the material. And spiritual, your ruh, the spiritual, the nutrition for it is a spiritual. For that, some people, when they feel so sad and depression, they think, oh, let me go eat outside and go to a restaurant, go here and there. No, now still you are feeding the materialistic, by the materialistic. You need the spiritual in order to be removing all of the wrong. Also, the salah will keep your ni'mat of Allah upon you. Your favor of Allah upon you, the salah will keep it, for you. Your money, your wealth, your health. It will remove any wrong and it will bring more barakah. In Sahih al-Jami' in for al-Albani 1671, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ إِذَا قَامَ يُصَلِّي أُوتِيَ بِذُنُوبِهِ كُلُّهَا فَوُضِعَتْ عَلَى رَأْسِهِ وَعَاتِقَيْهِ فَكُلَّمَا رَكَعَ أَوْ سَجَدَ تَسَاقَطَتْ عَنْهُ. When you stand for the prayer praying, all of your sin will be put upon your shoulder. When you put your head, and it will be upon his shoulder and his head. When he do ruku and sujood, all of the sins will be filled down from him. For that, do a lot of ruku, do a lot of sujood. You will be rewarded from Allah. قال سلمان الفارسي رضي الله عنه في الزهد ابن المبارك الصلاة مكيال وميزان فمن أوفى أوفى الله له ومن طفف فقد علمتم ما قال الله في المطففين. صلاة is like a ميزان, like the balance. Whoever do it good, he will have goodness from Allah. Whoever does not do it, then you already know what Allah say about those people. وقال ابن القيم في مفتاح دار السعادة في الجزء الأول والفزع إلى الصلاة كمن شفيا به من علي من كم من كم قد شفيا به من عليل وكم قد عوفيا به من مريض. Going to the prayer, a lot of people already get healed, and their sickness removed because of their prayer, and they will be healthy after was being sick only because of the prayer. Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Nasr qala wa la na'lamu ta'atan yadfa'u Allah biha al-'adhab misl as-salah. He said, I don't know any obeying of Allah will remove the punishment of Allah from you equal to the salah. Wa fi zad al-ma'ad ibn al-qayyim qala as-salatu akbaru al-'awn على تحصيل مصالح الدنيا والآخرة ودفع مفاسد الدنيا والآخرة. He said, the salah is the biggest helper for you to get all goodness of dunya and akhirah, and to remove and be safe from all bad إن دنيا إن آخرة. اللهم اجعلنا مقيمين للصلاة مؤدين للزكاة يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم اجعلنا مقيمين للصلاة مؤدين للزكاة يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم اجعلنا مقيمين للصلاة مؤدين للزكاة. وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. وجزانا وجزاكم الله خيرا. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله. نسي إن شاء الله after رمضان أن أسك الله to bless your member us in the best of your دعاء إن شاء الله. والسلام عليكم.